Hi guys, welcome back. Today I'm here to talk about Serpent and Dove by Shelby Mahurin. Serpent and Dove is a debut new adult fantasy romance coming out in September. And I recently read it, I really enjoyed it, and I want to talk a little bit about what this book is, what it does well, and who I think is going to enjoy this. This is set in a French-inspired world. The chasseurs, I don't know if I'm saying that right, because I do not speak French, so excuse my pronunciation, but the chasseurs are an elite military organization belonging to the church, and their purpose is to hunt down and kill witches. So, of course, the main plot of this book involves a marriage of convenience between Louise, who's hiding the fact that she's a witch, and Reed, who is the captain of the chasseurs. So, I mean, you know where that's gonna go. So this is obviously like a secret enemies to lovers with a marriage of convenience plot, which I love. This is one of my favorite romances that I've read this year, and even though some of the other elements of this book were not done perfectly, and we're gonna get into that, I think if you are looking for a good fantasy romance, this is a very solid pick. It's super enjoyable, it's easy to read, it's well-paced, the world is interesting, the two main characters have such a good romance, it's so good. It's so well done. It just like made me really happy. I loved that. For me, this was a 5-star read, reading it as a fantasy romance. Hey guys, editing Bethany here. I just wanted to pop in because I realized in all my talk of Serpent and Dove, I didn't talk much about the two main characters, which was one of my favorite parts of the book. I absolutely love them. Louise is hilarious. She is my sassy queen. She gets up to all kinds of antics and is strong and fierce and brave and also does wild things like sing bawdy barroom songs to these hyper-religious warriors until they give in and let her have what she's asking for, and she just cracks me up. One of my favorite characters. And Reed is the perfect foil for her. He's so serious and a perfectionist, but he's got some secrets hiding underneath, and they just have the best romance. I really loved it. I've ended up deciding that this book is going to be a favorite of the year for me, honestly, just because it was so enjoyable and something I would return to and definitely read again, even though, as I'm going to talk about, there were issues with it, especially it being a debut novel. It wasn't perfectly written, but it was still so, so good, and for me, it was definitely a new favorite. Okay, back to my previously filmed content for the review. This is being recommended for fans of Sarah J Maas, and I can definitely see why. There are similarities in the fact that both of them are new adult fantasy romances, which you don't get a whole lot of. This one is done really well. Similarly to her ACOTAR series, it's very easy to read. It's got some like swoony romance to it and some magic. And so I definitely think fans of that series will probably enjoy this. However, I also think that Serpent and Dove does some things better than what the ACOTAR series does. Some of the issues that I and other people have had with that series, and don't get me wrong, I enjoy the ACOTAR series for what it is, but I recognize some of the shortcomings. And this, I think, kind of corrects some of those problems. This one has a much more diverse cast of characters, it's more thematically rich, it doesn't include the same types of kind of problematic, abusive relationships. Another thing I really liked about Serpent and Dove is it kind of turns some traditional romance tropes on its head. In this case, while our heroine is not a virgin, our hero is, and so when they eventually consummate this marriage, that makes for some pretty interesting dynamics, and I just really enjoyed the way that that was done. I thought it was pretty cool and kind of overturned some of these sexist things that we sometimes see in terms of expecting women to be virgins and men never to be, so I just thought that was really fun. Thematically, this is doing some really interesting work. We get morally gray characters and organizations where the witches and the church are contentious and fighting each other and basically want to destroy each other, but neither of them are innocent. They both do bad things for reasons that they think are valid and good. And so it's pretty interesting. Like, you don't really have a lot of characters that are clearly all good or all bad. I like the way, too, that it's playing with, on one side, this kind of extreme version of feminism, like a men don't matter as anything more than like for procreation purposes version of it, and women are magical and all powerful, versus on the other side, this very patriarchal, sexist church that views women more as property. And so you kind of get these two extremes and you see how both of them can be so problematic. And so it's really cool to eventually see Reed and Louise come together and learn and grow and compromise and find some middle ground and see the things that are valuable on both sides. I loved it. I love things like that. Like that just, it like totally worked for me as a romance. It was great. It was exactly what I wanted. Now, for the things that were not perfect. Number one, I really wanted to see more development of the side characters. They're very underdeveloped, which is unfortunate because they're interesting. Like, there's so much potential there, but they feel a little bit flat. While our two main characters are really well developed, and even some of the, like, almost villain-ish characters are more interesting, like, none of the side characters get the development that I would like to see them have. And so that was a little bit of a bummer. There's also a couple of continuity errors in this book that I'm hoping will maybe be fixed in the finished copy. This is an advanced reader copy, so maybe these will be fixed by there, but there's some things that get talked about and I'm like, did that happen? Wait a minute. And I flip back and I'm like, that never happened. Maybe that scene got cut and you forgot it got cut. I don't know. So there's like a couple of like minor things like that. And also some of the plot points definitely felt a little bit convenient. There were things that happened that I think a more experienced writer maybe would have kind of set the stage for or seeded out more thoroughly. And I think part of that just comes with this being a debut novel. I think if I were to rate this as just a fantasy, pure fantasy, this would probably be like a 4-star read for me. But because this is really a fantasy romance and because the romance was done so well, this was definitely 5 stars. As a fantasy romance. And that's the thing too, is as a genre, romance just tends to have more plot points that are a little bit convenient, and I'm kind of more okay with it in romance as a genre than I am in like high fantasy, for example, then I'm a little bit more like nitpicky about it. So those are my thoughts on Serpent and Dove. I thoroughly enjoyed this, and so I think if you're looking for a really well-executed fantasy romance that has more diverse characters and is a little bit more socially conscious, and you're looking for something that will fill that need of kind of like the ACOTAR type series but better, I would definitely recommend picking up Serpent and Dove by Shelby Mahurin. One thing that I will say about this book is I would probably place it in new adult, partly because the characters are a little older, and also because there is one sex scene near the end of the book that is semi-explicit. So if you're concerned about that, that is in there. I don't have a problem with it, but just so you're aware. There's also definitely going to be some content warnings associated with this. I would recommend checking out Goodreads if you're looking for a complete list of those, but there is definitely violence, there is threat of killing children, there's blood magic in here, so you get depictions of blood and cutting for the purposes of magic. Yeah, there's probably some other things as well. So definitely check that out if that's something that you are concerned about. Talk to me in the comments down below. Let me know any of your thoughts on anything that I said. And for your question of the day, just let me know if this is something that interests you, and if it does, why? Is this a book that you would pick up, or is this something you think you would pass on? Is fantasy romance your thing, or is that not really what you're looking for? Let me know. If you guys like this video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you want to see more. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.